Hello, my name is Joanna Mark. I'm a senior clinical application specialist with Philips Ultrasound. In this video, you will see a demonstration on how to acquire a GYN volume. After the video, you will be able to acquire and manipulate a data set of the uterus and or ovary. Volumetric acquisitions which is stored allow the offline review, manipulation and analysis of the data set to obtain the maximum information from a study. It allows the assessment of a variety of gynecological disorders including uterine anomalies, intrauterine device location, endometrial disorders, fibroids and ovarian pathology. First, we need to optimize our 2D image. An optimized 2D image provides a higher resolution 3D data set. We can do this by pressing iScan that optimizes 2D gain and TGC, or adjust settings such as X-rays, 2D opt, dynamic range, depth, and focus. Now push the 3D knob. On the touchscreen, you can select 3D or 4D. 3D is selected by default. By default, there is no region of interest or ROI box on your image. You can acquire a 3D data set immediately by pressing the middle button above the trackball or start 3D on the touchscreen. If a ROI is needed, press standby on the touchscreen or the middle button above the trackball, and then 3D ROI on the touchscreen. On the bottom of the monitor, you will see three options below the trackball diagram: 3D ROI position, 3D ROI curved adjust, and 3D ROI size. By pressing the buttons on the left and right of the trackball, you can go through these options and set the position, curve the volume view line, and change the size of your region of interest. Press Reset Curve to return the volume view line to a straight line if needed. Make sure to include all anatomy needed in the ROI box. Further settings can be changed to increase the resolution of the 3D dataset. Adjust the angle if a bigger or smaller sweep is needed. The 2D opt can be changed to res. A gen or pen setting is also available. On the second page of the touchscreen, changes can be made to chroma map and or the gray map. Press start 3D on the touchscreen or the middle button above the trackball to start the acquisition. Press standby on the touchscreen or the middle button above the trackball if you want to reacquire the dataset. On the monitor, you see the sagittal, transverse, and coronal plane of the uterus, as well as the volume image, numbered from 1 to 4. To manipulate the dataset at a later time, press Save 3D on the touchscreen. Another option is to save the three MPR plane sweeps as cine loops. On the second page of the touchscreen, press MPR Save and then Save MPRs. The active plane is surrounded by a yellow box. And on each MPR plane, we have a region of interest box indicated by the red, green, and blue boxes. The dotted line indicates where the volume image comes from, the direction of the volume view. On the bottom of the monitor around the trackball diagram, you will see the options available for the left and right buttons next to the trackball. Use these buttons and the trackball to change the position, the size of the ROI box, or the curve line. For example, if I want to change the ROI size on the transverse plane, I will select the transverse plane number 2 on the touchscreen. Use the buttons next to the trackball, select 3D ROI size, and move the trackball up and down or left and right to change the box size. Let's take a look at how we can manipulate the MPR plane. If needed, we can hide the volume image by pressing Hide Volume on the touchscreen. To find the area of interest, you can slice through a specific plane by selecting the plane on the touchscreen and turning the slice knob. Or turn the X, Y, and Z knobs to rotate a specific plane. At any time, you can press Reset Orientation on the touchscreen to return to the original orientation. To see an area of interest in all three MPR planes, move the cursor with the trackball to the area of interest. MPR Touch can also be used to manipulate the reference cursor on the touchscreen. If we did not hide the volume, use the pointer to activate the yellow cursor and move it to the area of interest. Press pointer again to go back to the 3D ROI options. Manipulating the volume image. Optimize the ROI boxes to see the desired volume image using the trackball and buttons next to it to adjust the size, position, and curve line of the ROI boxes. MPR Touch can also be used. Select the one-up layout on the touchscreen to view the volume image only. Press Rotate to rotate the volume image, or Quick Flip if needed. Rotate the X, Y, and Z knobs to align, or the Slice knob to slice through the volume image. Here you can also press Touch View to manipulate the volume image on the touchscreen. Different rendering options are available for the volume image. Press Vision on the touchscreen to see different options. The TrueView Vision have a light source that can be moved anywhere in your volume image, and by turning this rotary knob, you can change the light depth. Using TouchView, you can manipulate and zoom the image. With one tap on the touchscreen, you can move the light source or change the depth using the rotary knob. Threshold, transparency, and smoothing can be used to optimize the volume image. Select these on the touchscreen or press the rotary knob to select and then turn the knob to adjust. On the second page of the touchscreen, volume chroma, lighting, and bright is available if further optimization is needed. Let's go back to a four-up layout. The dotted line or volume view can be changed depending from which direction you want to view the dataset. Press Volume View. Notice how the dotted line changes position in the ROI boxes. Unneeded information can be erased from the volume image if needed. Select one up under Layout to display the volume image. On the touchscreen, press Sculpt. At the bottom of the monitor, you have the option between 3D Sculpt and 3D Erase. With 3D Sculpt, you see a green cross on the volume image. Move the cross to where you want to start removing information and press the middle button above the trackball. Move the trackball and draw the line around the information you want to delete and press the middle trackball button again. Select 3D Erase. with the button next to the trackball. A gray dot appears on the volume image. Move the dot to where you want to remove the information and press the middle button above the trackball. Slowly move the trackball to remove information from the volume image. When you removed incorrect information, press Undo on the touchscreen to get the information back. When done, press Close. Sculpt is also available when you are in TouchView. For 3D and 4D acquisitions, different settings are needed depending on the anatomy that you are looking at. After you have optimized your dataset and volume image, you can now save your settings, which include multiple 3D and 4D parameters, by pressing Save 3D Preset on the touchscreen. Provide a name for your preset, and you can directly use this in the future with all your settings saved, for example, an acquisition of the uterus or ovary. Additional functions includes Alt Print. This can be programmed to a printer. GI3DQ is a QLab application to manipulate the dataset. QLab is also available off-card. iSlice, the possibility to get a tomographic view of the volume. Thank you for watching. On how to use our FlexView option, please refer to the FlexView video.